Our work, thermography has a method of acquiring competences in physiology, application case for hand blood flow control. This work has been developed in the Applied Physiology Laboratory of the University of Leon. The present work proposes a methodological structure as a part of the learning of the circulatory system. The COVID-19 pandemic has forced drastic change to be made in the daily routine of teaching in health science. For this reason, with this closeness with the student is not achieved, audiovisual media can be useful to facilitate the acquisition of the necessary skill and the learning of techniques or practical procedure. Learning based on the visualization and analysis of the thermographic images allows the acquisition of a specific competence at the university level. In graduate studies such as physiotherapy and nursing, the use of visual tools and material that allow the acquisition of skill and technical knowledge is essential for the job performance of future professionals. For this, the application of thermal stress is used by immersing the hand in cold water to visualize the reperfusion of the hand. Thermography has been used in multiple fields, although our interest is focused on its use in the area of health science. Activity design, with the aim of generating virtualized teaching material that allow the acquisition of the competences related to human physiology and microcirculation. Said material will consist of a video tutorial related to the protocol for the evaluation of renal phenomena by thermography, which will be accompanied by the series of thermographic images. These images may be evaluated by the student according to the specific competence to be acquired in the subject question. In a pre-pandemic circumstances, the teaching activity would have been carried out on the premises of the Applied Physiology Laboratory in order to favor the interactivity of the student with the instrument and that they had a direct learning experience. Given the new context, the proposed thermography practice protocol was videotaped to facilitate learning about the effect of temperature on the circulatory system. Didactical structure of the video. The objective of the video is to carry out a practical demonstration of the procedure used for the temperature stress technique by immersing the hand in the cold water. Furthermore, it shows how the thermographic images should be collected before and after immersion in cold water for the study and determination of the revascularization time. As we can see in the following images, a 15-minute acclimatization time period is counted in the new environmental condition. This acclimatization is very important since the subject gate is used to the standardized condition, temperature, and humidity. In addition, it is shown in the video that from the first moment, vital signs are evaluated, otic temperature, blood pressure, and pulse. And the acclimatization period is over, the subject moves to the thermographic image collection area. The video shows how the control images are collected. After this phase, the passengers show how they are transferred to the head stress zone where to start the stress period by immersing their hand in cold water. At the end of this period, the patient takes your hand off the gloves and return to the thermographic image collection area to take a sequence of images. The sequence is configured as follows. Thus, they leave the student with a structured idea of the observed laboratory technique and allow the introduction of additional information that the student absorbs more easily. In conclusion, this didactic activity makes use of a virtual material that allows students to asynchronously deepen the study of human physiology, more specifically in blood circulation. In addition, the use of thermographic images increases the motivation of students that is, in an underused resource in the degree given its economic cost. As the main complementary benefit of the present methodology, it should be noted that virtual materials can be reused for different practices.